All right. Well, what's up, everybody? Thank you so much for joining me again. I got a vapey thing that I wanted to talk about today. This is another very cool mod from Vaporesso. This is the Polar Kit. Polar Kit dual 18650 high wattage 220 watt box mod. Comes with the Cascade Baby SE tank. I've got this set up right now with the Recoil Rebel on top, and it's in wattage mode, 3.5 volts. It's fast, it's quick, it's responsive. I've really enjoyed this mod. So the Polar mod comes with the Omni board 4.0, which is a very nice board. Like I said, it's real quick, real responsive, real powerful, and it also comes with a pretty big amount of safety features included. Things like reverse battery, short circuit, over discharge, overcharge protection, things like this. This is the same board that is in that Vaporesso Armor Pro kit that I reviewed not too long ago, and it does include that SP mode, which I didn't know what it did before, but now I know what it does. SP apparently stands for Super Player Mode. And Super Player Mode, from what I can understand, is like their high performance mode. It will offer the widest range of resistances that you can use on it. It says it can fire down to a 0.03 and all the way up to a 5 ohm coil. Seems kind of weird if you're going to run a 0.03 resistance coil on this. Just please don't do that. Running a 0.03 on this, even if you wanted to run it only at like 3 volts, you're still going to be pulling over 100 amps from your battery. So just don't do it. It can do it, but you shouldn't do it. The screen on this Vaporesso Polar Kit is just a gorgeous screen. It's a big, full-color, 2-inch screen. You can always see exactly what's going on. You can see your battery levels, you can see your voltage, you can see your resistance, you can see your amps, you can see what mode you're in. A long press on the center button down here will get you into the menu system. The menu system itself is very, very intuitive. You can swap around anything that you want to swap around. You can go from variable wattage mode to variable voltage mode. You can have curves and variable wattage and variable voltage. You can use that SP. You can use temperature control for all sorts of different coils. You can change the settings. You can change the brightness. You can change, the color that your screen is. You can set the time on there, which the time itself is actually incredibly useful. Before I got any of these Vaporesso mods, whether it's that Armor Pro kit or whether it's this Polar kit, I kind of always poked fun at showing, displaying the time on mods. But it turns out when you have a real pretty display like this, looking down at your mod and seeing the time is actually a pretty freaking useful thing. So like I said, this does come with the Cascade Baby SE tank, which is a fine tank. It is kind of ugly though, isn't it? I'm not a big fan of bubble glass on tanks anyway, and I personally think that this is just a really super ugly tank. The fit and finish on it is quite nice. It's got an AFC on the bottom that you can go from full open to full closed. It's nice and smooth and glidey. You unscrew the bottom to put your coil head in the base. The rest of the tank is reverse threaded, and it does come completely apart if you want to, take it apart and clean it or anything like that. It's got the same sort of pull and twist top fill system that the other Cascade tank from the Armor Pro kit had. I don't love the drip tip that it comes with, mostly because it's kind of big and awkward, and it also doesn't fit down in the tank as well as I would like. Every time I look down at this, I can see that it's leaning off to one side, and you get that little bit of like gap that happens in there. And even right now, just looking at it, I don't even need to hold it up to the light. I can see that it's seated real well on one side, and then the other side, there's just a big gap there. So now that I've got this Cascade Baby SE tank on here, this is the 0.15 ohm what are these called? GT8 coils. These are the traditional round wire coil heads with, you know, the four coils in the coil head. It works fine. It vapes fine. It's just not my favorite. The GT1 mesh coil head that this comes with as well is a far, far superior coil head. After using mesh coil heads in a sub-ohm tank, it's honestly a little bit of a struggle for me to go back and use round wire based coil heads. It's a noticeable difference in the quality of vape. But these are the 0.15 GT8 coil head in here. I have it sitting at 3.3 volts because adjusting the volts is my preferred way to vape on these Polar, you know, Vaporesso Polar Kit, the Vaporesso Armor Pro. They both do variable voltage, which I really like. And it's honestly a fine vape. This is loaded up with River Float from Bonsai Vapors. Tastes good, vapes good. I'm just gonna go ahead and put an RDA back on here because that tank is just ugly. And I realize that's a purely subjective statement to me. In my opinion, that tank is just real ugly. I'm the one that has to use my mods. I'm the one that has to look at it. And I personally don't really like using or looking at that tank. Not necessarily using. I like using that tank. I just think it's ugly personally, just to me. If you think that tank looks dope, then that's fine. Just use it and enjoy it and think it's dope. I'm not gonna judge you for using the Cascade Baby SE tank. The Omni Board 4.0 also offers a bypass mode, which is 4 volts, just a regulated 4 volts. They call it bypass mode, but it is actually just a regulated 4 volts, and it feels very strong. It feels very intense. Even with this Recoil Rebel on here with a 0.13 dual aliens in here, I'm only running it at about 3.4 volts. The 4-volt bypass mode for these particular coils is just a bit too much. If you're after a really hot vape, like borderline like series style vape, the bypass mode is gonna hit hard and it's gonna hit powerfully. But even set at 3.4 volts with these 0.13 dual aliens in here, it's still hitting nice and hard. The mod itself, real quick, really responsive mod. It just feels like a high performance mod. Overall, the fit and finish on this, nice. Just feels good. Feels real techy, feels real nice in the hand, and it also feels quite durable as well. It's a real ergonomic shape. I can fit it in my hand. I have no problem holding it and hitting that fire button with my finger, alternatively flipping it around and hitting that fire button with my thumb. It's just overall, any way you want to use it, it's comfy. The button itself is a little bit on the long side and it's got like this little bit of record player texture to it, which I don't know. I like it. I like that little bit of texture on the button. This button is a little bit long and you can click it on the bottom and it takes a lot more, you know, pressure to get it to click, but it will click and it will fire. I just hit it right at the top. I find that it's much easier and it's real clicky. Oh, hearing the clickiness happening right there? God, I love a good clicky button. There is a little tab on the back of the door that's like it's just a weak, barely little there cutout to just kind of get in there and pull the door off. 10 times out of 10, I don't even use that. You can just grab the back and just pull it off. It's only held on by magnets. Whoops. It's only held on by magnets, but it feels very secure when it's on. There's no ribbon for your batteries or anything like that, but they protrude out. When you take the door off, they protrude out so much that you can kind of just grab them and pull them straight out. It's spring-loaded on the top, and so no matter how your batteries are going in, they go in series. So this one, the positive is pointing up. This one, the positive is facing down. But just remember that the top is what is spring-loaded. And when you pop the batteries in, you don't have to turn it on. It goes through a little boot-up sequence, and it takes you exactly to where you were. With that Vaporesso Armor Pro kit, I was having issues with when you take out the batteries and you put them back in using variable voltage mode, it defaulted to the highest voltage, which was 9 volts. That doesn't seem to be the case with the Polar kit. I can take my batteries out and I can put them back in and it'll remember, oh look, right there, GrimmGreen was vaping at 3.4 volts and it remembers it and brings me back to the same voltage on the same screen. I'm not sure why the Armor Pro kit does one thing and the Polar kit does another thing, considering they're running the same Omniboard 4.0 on the inside. These mods do also come in just a rainbow of freaking colors. I opened up the little green to black gradient one, which I think looks very, very cool, but they also have like a red to black, a blue to black gradient. They do just straight up silver, black, and gold, and red, and blue, I believe, as well. And all of the colors, in my opinion, look very slick. This mod overall just looks and feels very slick. It feels like a sports car. Just so quick and responsive and so powerful. So let's get down to brass tacks here. You're gonna need your vape budget hands for the Vaporesso Polar kit. Maybe a little bit. Clicking around the internet, I found it anywhere from $60 to $65, which is, you know, a little bit of an investment, but you're getting a dual 18650 220 watt high performance responsive box mod with a beautiful screen on it, a really intuitive interface. It can do wattage and voltage and temp control and bypass and super player mode as well. And you're also getting the very serviceable Cascade Baby SE tank, which isn't my favorite looking tank, but the coil heads on the inside, especially the mesh, the GT1 mesh coil heads, are awesome. Just awesome coil heads. Now, if we're going to play the Aliens game or the FDA game where they come and take everything I have and I have nothing left to vape, is the Vaporesso Polar Kit something I would seek out and buy right away? That is a really hard question to say no to. I am enjoying using this mod so much that I kind of just want to say yes. I'm just not in love with that Cascade Baby SE tank. If there was an option to just buy just the Polar mod so that I could run my own tanks and my own RDAs on it for maybe a little bit lower of a price, like if I could get just the Polar mod for like $45 or $50, I feel like it would kind of be a no-brainer. Although, if I'm being real honest, I do feel like that Inokin Proton mod would kind of give this one a run for its money. Like I said, they're so evenly matched. I would genuinely have a hard time choosing between the two. But anyway, that's enough rambling from me. It is what it is. It's the Vaporesso Polar Kit. Been very surprised, honestly, and very impressed with the products that Vaporesso has been releasing lately. I did not have high hopes for a lot of these new Vaporesso products, and I am very, very glad to say that they have basically surprised me in every way possible. But anyway, it is what it is. Vaporesso Polar Kit, thank you guys so much for watching. And as always, yeah, dude, let's keep on vaping.